that I've been really honored to work with the level of team members that I have been a part of in the last several days. I can't stress enough that their amazing attitude, compassion, and the quality of care they've provided under these circumstances. So I just wanted to say thank you to them because they've done an incredible job to be a part of this.
Thank you.
So, well,
how is the patient doing now? How is she? Can you talk about her condition now?
We're just maintaining her privacy, and we won't be able to talk about her specific condition.
So it's not Ebola, but do you have any other ideas?
We're continuing to treat her as we would any other medical patient.
Can you tell us what it's like to get in and get out of the scrubs and to deal with someone you thought might have had Ebola? What was that like?
You know, the one thing that we've emphasized the whole time is safety. So we've had a 5-person care team dedicated to her at any given time. And one of the things that we've really worked on is having one individual dedicated to just reading a script. One person's directly monitoring a person getting in and out of that protective equipment, and we've stuck by that religiously 24 hours a day with every single instance. It is definitely a process. It's very thorough. It takes a bit of time, but we've been very proactive about making sure we, you know, check it off every step of the way so it doesn't change at all.
So one person has a list, and you're just like, first you put the boots on, and then you do that. Next you do
absolutely.
This.
Absolutely. It's very prescribed. We've gone through with infection prevention, safety, you know, CDC guidelines, and we've got a very rigorous script, if you will, that says exactly every step of the way, and we don't deviate from it. What I can tell you is that it's a specialized skill to be in these suits that we've been practicing. We don't let people go in just one time in the donned outfit and go. They need to go through the specialized training, and we've been practicing that because, you know, you're double gloved, and so the dexterity is a little difficult, but we maintain that for safety.
You talk a lot about practicing and preparing. How much value in there is there, and actually the fact that you had to do this for 2 days and doing it, the real thing?
It's been incredible to have the ability to train and prepare in advance. We'll continue to train and prepare, and we've made some adjustments as we go, like you spoke about. The real event is continued, you know, practice of our steps, and it was, you know, I'm thankful that we had the opportunity to prepare that we did.